Michael Patton here for wannabe theologians in Camaros drinking Diet Dr. Pepper. My nephew gave me this question. It is, and it's a very common question. Is suicide an unforgivable sin? Now, the first thing that I usually think, and you may think, is where do we ever get the idea that it's an unforgivable sin? I mean, why isn't, is murder an unforgivable sin? Or is, rape an unforgivable sin? Why is it always, is suicide an unforgivable sin? Right when we got married, my wife and we were talking about this, and she was under the impression that for some reason it was an unforgivable sin. Even though she knew the gospel and everything else, she, for some reason, held on to this. And how did that get tied into the folklore that we often have as Christians, that suicide is an unforgivable sin? Well, the where it comes from is from the Roman Catholic understanding of mortal and venial sins. A venial sin are those sins that you commit every day that aren't as serious. A mortal sin is one that is very serious. It is one that you have to do penance for and have to have some type of restitution in order to be forgiven for. That's where you go to the priest, and the priest tells you, these days it's pretty easy to get restitution for sins. You know, say a few Hail Marys or something like that. Back in the day, it was do a pilgrimage to Israel or go on a crusade. But the mortal sins are those sins that are serious, that include adultery, usually the Ten Commandments. There's a few stipulations for a mortal sin to be a mortal sin. It has to be grave, it has to be intentional, and it has to be, I believe it's not forced from the outside. Or you have to be in your right mind as well. But suicide being the unforgivable sin is because murder is an unforgivable sin. And since you cannot seek restitution for suicide, because you're dead, therefore it becomes the unforgivable sin, or an unforgivable sin within Roman Catholic theology. Now that's somehow transferred over into a lot of American theology, that suicide is an unforgivable sin. But that's simply untrue. I mean, I certainly don't want anybody to, you know, take this as a license to commit suicide. My sister committed suicide, and I feel as if that was some of the reasoning behind that, and there was just really nothing I could do except for give her bad theology. My mom actually tried to give her that before she died, whenever she was trying to kill herself. Golly, this has turned into a sad video. She asked me, she said, Michael, would you tell Angie that suicide is an unforgivable sin? And I said, no, I can't do that. Maybe looking back, I might do it today, you know, seeing that she did that. I don't know. I probably wouldn't. But either way, suicide is not an unforgivable sin. I mean, there's no reason to think that the cross did not cover suicide. Those of you who have had loved ones who have committed suicide and were wondering this question, please know that the cross of Christ, whenever you trust in Christ, takes care of all sins, past, present, and future. And we don't sin because we love Him, not so that He will love us.